Hi, welcome to the Light of Deception. Today I'm going to be talking about what it means to be selfish and versus what it means to be selfless. And what does the Bible say about the seasons and the times that we're living in? That people would be more selfless or more selfish? Well, the scripture says, and we're going to start off with Philippians 2, 3, and 4, says here, let nothing be done through selfish ambition or conceit, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem others better than themselves. Let each of you look out not only for his own interests, but also for the interest of others. So that sounds like it's leaning towards selfless and not selfish. But the world today is teaching a new doctrine, a doctrine of self, self-arrival, self-care, self-first, instead of the opposite of dying to self. So what I'm looking at is many scriptures here, and this is called perilous times and perilous men. 2 Timothy 3, 1 through 5 states, but know this, that in the last days, perilous times will come, for men will be lovers of themselves, lover of money, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, thankful, unthankful, unholy, unloving, unforgiving, slanderers without self-control, brutal, despisers of good, traitors, this is so true, headstrong, haughty, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying its power, and from such people, turn away. This is the time we're living in because everything is about man. Everything's about what man can do. Man arriving at self, man facing off with God, man, you know, doing all these things that they say is coming from God. Latter day, the prophets that are false prophets, you know, they're some of them are hirelings. They're paid to come in and confuse you and deceive you. Right? Some are just deceived, so they're falling into that narrative of the latter-day prophets and saints, right? They have extra revelations that don't come to fruition. Therefore, they are false prophets, leading many astray. So be careful. People are so selfish into their own self-topical teachings, into self, you know, the saying positive things to people instead of giving them the hard truths. Where's the bold people out there that are ready to step out in faith and truly teach the entirety of scripture from Genesis to Revelation? Talking about the end time prophecies, talking about the times and the seasons we're living in, talking about eschatology, not leaving out not one iota of scripture, but teaching it in its entirety, even when it gets hard, even when people don't like to hear it. Because sometimes when you don't like to hear it and you're stomping out of a church, it's because it's really getting to you, it's convicting you, you need to repent and turn from your wicked ways. Sin is the reason that we are condemned to death, right? That Jesus paid the ultimate price for all of us and gave everything in his innocence and perfection. He took on the body of a man and died as a ransom for us fallen mankind in need of a savior. If you could arrive at yourself and get there yourself, then Jesus died for nothing. So this is the season and the times we're living in. Now, I want to talk to you a little bit about some of these scriptures that tell you about the end of yourself, not the beginning of yourself. So in Philippians 2, 4, look not at every man on his own things, but every man also on the things of others. Care for others. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul, strength, right? And love your neighbor as yourself. You are last. It's so easy to put self first. That's why you wax cold, because all you are about your day, yourself. You can't see outside your own needs. Luke 6:35 says, but love ye your enemies, and do good, and lend, hoping for nothing again, and your reward shall be great, and ye shall be the children of the highest. For he is kind unto the unthankful and to the evil. That means you're going to be kind to both, those who are kind to you. That's anybody can do that, but it's being kind to the unkind. that this is calling you to do, right? 1 Peter 3:8, finally, be ye all of one mind, having compassion on one another. Love as brethren, be pitiful, be courteous. There you go. John 15:12-14, this is my commandment, that ye love one another as I have loved you. Philippians 2:3, let nothing be done through strife or vain glory, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem others better than themselves. 2 Peter 1:5-7. And besides this, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, and to virtue knowledge. 1 Thessalonians 5:15. See that none render evil for evil unto any man, but ever follow that which is good, both among yourselves and to all men. Ephesians 4:29-32, let no corrupt communication proceed from your mouth, but that which is good to use of edifying, that it may minister grace unto the hearers. Proverbs 19:17, he that hath pity upon the poor lendeth unto the Lord, and that which he hath given will be paid him again. 1 Timothy 6:17-19, charge them that are rich in the world that they be not high-minded, nor trust in certain riches, but in the living God, who giveth us richly all things to enjoy. Galatians 5:14, for all the law is fulfilled in one word, even this is, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. That is the first commandment. You love God first and love your neighbor as yourself. How can you do that if you just keep positive selfisms going? Now it's okay to eat healthy and take care of your health, because that's biblical too, right? To take care of your health. But are we not supposed to be thinking of others, right? That are hurting, that are grieving, that need to know the Lord, that have not salvation but live in the world, that are hopeless during these times. As the times are getting darker and darker, people need to know that you care, that you love them, that you think of them, right? And you go to them in their time of need. You rejoice with them. So you are being what God calls you to be. We are going to be not first. It says the first will be last and the last will be first, right? So we are going to be servants, as Jesus was a servant here. He came to serve, right? Well, he'll be coming as judge next. Okay, next, let's look at Galatians 2:20. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. That's it. He was a sacrifice for you. Luke 9:23. And he said to them all, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. It's a denying of self. And Galatians 5:24, and they that are Christ's have crucified the flesh with the affections and lust. Mark 8:35. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it, but whosoever shall lose his life for my sake and the gospel, the same shall save it. John 12:24, verily, verily, I say unto you, except a corn of wheat fall into the ground and die, it abideth alone, but if it die, it bringeth forth much fruit. Romans 6:1-23. This is actually going to just be part of that. What shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? Absolutely not. Matthew 10:38. And he that taketh not the cross and follows after me is not worthy of me. Philippians 2:1-30. We won't read this whole thing, but just a portion. If there be, therefore, any consolation in Christ, if any comfort of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any bowels are mercies. 1 Corinthians 15:31. I protest by your rejoicing, which I have in Christ Jesus, our Lord, I die daily. You're dying to self daily. 1 Peter 2:24. Who his own self bared our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, being dead in sin, shall live unto righteousness, by whose stripes ye were healed. 1 Peter 4:1-11. For as much then as Christ hath suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourself likewise with the same mind, for you that hath suffered in the flesh hath ceased from sin. There you go. Colossians 3:3. For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. See, it's not about you. Romans 12:1. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, wholly acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Your servant. 2 Corinthians 3:17. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. You are new. You are not the man you used to be. You have turned from your and repented from your sins, and you are following after Christ. Not that you won't sin and trip up, because you will, because we are still in the flesh, but we are changing, being sanctified day by day. 2 Corinthians 4:8. We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not despair, right? We are not giving into despair. Philippians 1:21, for to me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. So I think about the people that have gone before us, that have given everything for Christ, that have really lived that life. They are not perfect men. They have to repent of their sins daily. Your thoughts are not good. Your actions are not good sometimes. You might say something you didn't mean. You might think something you shouldn't be thinking, but in all your ways you follow him, right? He will direct your path. You will turn from those ways daily, your fleshly carnal ways, and you will be changed. So the scriptures are telling you to die to self. The world is telling you to arrive at self, right? They're always talking about positivism, self-care, self-arrival, self, going within to find God. There's nothing good in you. There's nothing good in your carnal nature. There's nothing good in you. One is God, good, and that is God. So when God takes your life and you surrender all things and you abandon the life that you once lived and you lay it flat at the cross, you will get back up in his strength and not in your own. For when you are weak, he is strong. He will lead you into all truth. The scriptures will give it all to you. All scripture is given by inspiration of God. I never forget that. It will reproof, it will correct you, and it will lead you in all righteousness. That is all you need. The word of God, your plumb line will always be the word of God. Read it from start to finish. You will learn every single time that you read in the Old and the New Testament, and you see how it works together from start to finish. God will show you the way. He is the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except through him. And I leave you with that today. Thank you for listening. If you're really learning a lot here at the Light of Deception, we have a Straight Talk Light of Deception Ministries as well, which I have guest speakers on the program now. Next, we'll be talking to Billy. He will be talking about faith in the trials of life. We surely need to hear that, what the Bible says about faith in the trials of life. No matter what comes your way, God will get you through, right? And also, to die is gain. So we always have to think about that. It's like we live our life, we occupy, we fill the gap. If we're raptured with the church or we are called away at our death, we meet a holy God at the end of our lives. And I pray that helps you here. I know you want to hear this. I know I do. Well done, good and faithful. You leave nothing behind. You lay it all out at the cross and you run that race and you toss your burdens upon a holy God. and he will get you through in his strength and not your own. So you're going to look up as your redemption draws near. Remember to subscribe to this channel so we can reach more people. Share what you find here forward so other people can hear Jesus is the way. That's all that matters. Remember that. Thank you. Until next time. Bye-bye.